Welcome to another video featuring my Potter PFC-4410 fire alarm panel. Today, we're going to be going over programming. So I'm going to take the door off of this. Got this junk. Still got a couple troubles on here, but we're going to disregard that for now and switch over to programming mode. Okay, so look at history. I think I'm going to select that. We're going to look at some history, local silence. That's when I acknowledge the most recent trouble. We got a battery trouble, output one, zone two, reset. So that's some of the stuff we did at the panel. We'll hit the function key again to go to the next set of functions. We could set time. I'm not going to set the time because each time I power this down, the timer sets to zero. Password. It's all zeros, so I'm going to just skip. Nope, I guess I have to hit the set button three times. There we go. Initiating zone one. So this is where you can go to enable and disable. So we can set that two, and we can select this to change the state. Zone two is also enabled, three is enabled, four is enabled. All the outputs are enabled. System mode is normal. We could select between that and one-man walk test. I'm going to keep it on normal for now. Program zero, that's what we want. That's the custom program. That means we can do whatever we want. This panel actually has some preset programs for different types of systems, whether they be pre-action, fire alarm, cross-zoned pre-action, where you need more than one zone to activate in order to trip the solenoid. Also, it also has pre-configured outputs when you select these other programs. So I'm going to skip here. This is where it allows you to select between what you want the zones to do. So I'm going to hit set, or I'm going to hit select, and we could have it as water flow, linear heat. That's a linear heat is a pair of wires that, when exposed to high temperatures, they fuse together and short the zone, causing an alarm. Manual dump, that would be like a manual station to immediately release the solenoid or the chemical fire suppression. Supervisory, tamper, low air, high air, water flow. So, let's see. Oh, we skipped conventional. Let's go back. We want it on conventional, which is just a normal fire zone. I'm going to hit set. Zone 2, we want that. 3, 4. Zone 5 is supervisory, and I think that's just the default because that, I believe, is zone 5 right there where it says supervisory. Next, output 1. We could have it as indicating. Now we're going to go to, I think we're going to go to set 2, indicating the options, I believe. Let's step through the options. I'll select releasing. Nope, we don't want releasing. That would be for like a solenoid. Supervisory bell, trouble bell. So we want it as indicating, which is just our normal fire alarm signals. Because I have this, I'm configuring this as a fire panel. So we're going to go to the next one. I have that one configured as a trouble bell, which I will demonstrate at some point. Discharge time continuous. We could just disregard that because we're not doing discharge. Okay, we're going to skip this. This is just which inputs we want to map with each output. So we're not going to touch that. Just going to keep stepping through. Banner message. So we are going to set that. So we're going to keep that as lose FACP. Bottom line, I'm going to hit select. I'm going to change this. This is not default. I changed it to this. I'm going to, it would be funny if I just said bottom text as a joke, like that internet meme, but I'm not going to do that because then I have to step through the whole programming menu again. So I'm just going to say PFC-4410. I'm just going to go up. Skip to the space. Oh, shoot. Now I'm going to have to step through the whole thing again. Let's see, this is what we have zone one as. I made it by floor just to simulate a three-story building, or a two-story building with an attic, rather. So we'll just step through that. Floor one. Let's see. Attic. New password. I'm just going to skip that. Now it's going to make me push the programming switch back left. I'm going to go through again and fix that mistake I made with the bottom text. But I'm not going to show you that. We got in trouble. I'm not going to show you that because you already saw how I did it and it's going to double the length of the video. So we'll end that here. And then the next video is going to be me testing all of the zones and having some notification devices connected to the system. All right, well, thank you for watching. Catch you later.